Here's a 3D printer. It makes precision parts out of titanium powder. This machine costs $1.2 million. But before we get to this 3D printer, let's check out this one. It's a lot cheaper, and it makes things out of plastic, like this incredibly cool Fox 10 logo. When you spin it, you can see the 10 on each end and Fox in the middle. How did the folks at Titan Industries in Tempe make it? They started with a computer to make the design.
So that part, we digitally made a block, and then we made a Fox and a 10 projections that we cut away the material in order to make that complex design.
The printer follows the computer's instructions one super thin layer at a time.
So 3D printing is a term for a bunch of processes that essentially is manufactured direct from a digital file, layer by layer, to build the parts. As opposed to taking a block of material and cutting away, we build it additively, layer by layer.
It's kind of like putting a bunch of wafers on top of each other?
Yeah, it's like a 2D printer, sheets and sheets of each cross-section, stacking them up to get a three-dimensional part.
The Fox 10 piece took the printer 3 hours to make, and it came out great. Same with this tiny plastic drone Titan Industries also made using a 3D printer. Check it out. Computer design, controlled from a smartphone. It even does flips on command. Making something this sophisticated, that's how precise 3D printers are. Okay, now let's get back to this giant $1.2 million titanium powder 3D printer. Titan Industries has teamed up with LAI International, a precision parts maker. What they're doing here is taking a special metal powder, titanium powder, just as strong as steel but only weighs half as much. An electron beam turns a tiny bit of that titanium powder into metal.
So inside it gets about to about 3,500 degrees.
3,500 degrees?
Yes.
That's like is that like the surface of the sun?
The surface of the sun is a little bit warmer, but close.
That's crazy hot.
It is, yes.
And what does it do with all that heat?
Melts metal.
This super high-tech 3D printer makes a 90 micron layer. That's about the thickness of a human hair. Layer after layer after layer. 3 days later, the part is ready. It's inside a bed of powder. This powder recovery system cleans off the part. Titan Industries invited me to do the job. But first I had to put on a protective suit they call the bunny suit.
Now that I'm wearing all of this protective gear, known as the bunny suit, of course, what I'm doing is blowing all of this titanium dust off of this part that was created with that 3D printer.
The titanium powder is saved for future use, and there's the part. Parts like these are used on airplanes. Titan Industries says right now 1 in 2,000 parts on a plane is made by 3D printers. But get this, in 10 years, they expect 1 out of every 3 parts will be made this way. It's also perfect for space satellites and rockets. A good fit for the folks at Titan Industries.
We were formerly rocket scientists, and we decided to get into titanium 3D printing. We really specialized our engineering firm on this technology.
But you don't have to be a rocket scientist to do this.
You don't have to be.
Or do you?
But it helps.
In Tempe, Steve Krafft, Fox 10 News.